Heavenly Father God, in the name of your Son Jesus Christ, we praise you, Lord. We honor you, we glorify you, Lord God. Glory be to you, Lord God. We are gathering here in your in the name of Jesus to serve you, to worship you, Lord God, and also to hear you speaking to us. But to meditate on your word, Lord, speak to us. Use your servant, Lord, mightily. Let your spirit work in us and use your servant to proclaim your gospel. Have mercy on us, Lord. Bless us all. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. Dear friends, I'm sure all of you are making preparation for Christmas. Maybe some of you have completed your preparation. Maybe some are still worried about what to prepare and so on and so on. Christians are like that throughout the whole world. They make preparation for Christmas. They think about a lot of things. The first thing, of course, that we think when we are preparing for Christmas is Christmas tree. Our Christmas tree here. It's beautiful, but you know that the original Christmas tree is evergreen because it is always green. Even though the snow falls, the snow may be very thick. I think many of you have not seen snow. I have seen snow very thick. A lot of trees die. And all the leaves have fallen down. But the evergreen trees are still green. Very green. That is right. It symbolizes, yeah, the word of God. Eternal life. Salvation. The evergreen trees are found in Europe, in China, in Japan, but do you know that we have our pine trees here in Sumatra? Check your botany book. Our green trees we call Kusam. Kusam in Sumatra. Check your botany book. Has been here for millions of years. And the Kusam trees are very green trees. If the snow comes here, if snow comes, I think our Kusam can stand. All the other trees will die. So, I have great respect for our pine trees, especially from Prestige. And if you go to Dampadoli, you see a lot of Kusam, we call it in Indonesia. And of course, you know, the wood can be used as a torch. Torch at night. Long ago, people did not have torch lights, but they had Kusam trees they cut and they dried in the sun. And they produce it to light the darkness. Light the darkness. We prepare other things for Christmas. I think it is right for us to make a lot of preparation for Christmas. Because it is usual for Christians to prepare for Christmas. Rich or poor, they can prepare something for Christmas. In the big cities, even now already, I think that if you are in New York now, you will see carnivals like procession in the main street with all kinds of decoration, marching. I was there. I was preaching at Christ Church, Methodist Church, and then the carnival came and said, I mentioned that in my sermon. You have great carnivals here in New York. In Indonesia, we don't have carnivals like that. We may be, you know, disturbed by people if you do that. But even in the countryside, like the villages, you try to go to the villages. They are excited when they are preparing for Christmas. Of course, they wanted to use their new shirt, new gloves, and so on. And it is always rejoicing, my friend, even in the villages. Long ago during the war, Japanese war, my father had to join the guerrilla warfare, fighting happened that it was Christmas time. What should we do? The people were rejoicing and I was looking for my father. And I noticed that they were rejoicing and it was raining. They did not have umbrellas to go to the church. You know what they did? They cut the banana leaves very easy. Banana leaves, they cut the banana leaves and they went to the church. They used the banana leaves as umbrellas. They were rejoicing, they were singing. And the church, they pronounced all the messages, all the prophecies of the Bible about the coming of Jesus. My dear friends, it is right, I think, for Christians to make preparation for Christmas. We rejoice, we are happy. And we are happy also that we have young people who will be confirmed today, and some will be received into membership. And we are very happy to have visitors, our friends from Singapore. We are very glad to have you. I hope that more and more Singaporeans will come here and serve God. We miss your God. Yes, I am studying in Singapore. I studied at Trinity Theological College long ago. If I go there now, I don't even know where it is now. That time, Trinity College was so close to Wesley Church. We just crossed over and then had no Wesley Church. If I did not have any practical work between the churches, I went there to worship God. In 1961, we may think that it was the Holy Group. The Holy Group is not. We sang Elijah. This is what we call oratorio, Elijah. Hundreds of pages. I was there so weak. I was Elijah. Singing the word of discouragement at first, but then they brought the encouragement. My dear friends, prepare for Christmas, and I'm so glad that Singaporeans come here, but actually they should be preparing for Christmas at home. But this is good preparation. You come to visit us. We are encouraged by your coming. We'd like to go to Singapore, but maybe you don't have enough money because it's very expensive. But come here, it is cheaper here, my friends. Don't be afraid to come here. Last time I met some benign people. And one of them said, my wife was born in Medan, you know. And they said, why don't you come to Medan? At that time I was president of the Methodist University. I had enough power to send their cars to Tovale. So I said to the couple, come to Medan, I will send you to Tovale. Come. So that you can see the beauty of Tovale. And you know what he said? I don't want to do it. Why is it? There are many Mata people there. So why? Why is it? Why is it? Oh, Mata people are fierce. No, no, no. They are fine people. Come and visit us. Yeah. While you prepare for Christmas, come and visit us. Why prepare for Christmas, my dear friends? Why do we make preparation for Christmas? Because Christmas, which is the time when we remember the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Very beautiful. The coming of the light. As the Bible says to us, arise, your light has come. That's light. There is hope. Long ago, the world was full of sadness. Angry, dark. There was a pastor. I read a book about a pastor who, before Christmas, he was preparing his sermon about joy, about salvation, about future hope, and eternal life. But he was sleeping and he overslept. And it was Christmas morning already. Maybe he worked too hard to prepare his sermon. So he overslept. And he slept a long time. And he dreamt about the time before Jesus came to the world. He dreamt and he dreamt. And in his dream, he took his books, and there was no news about Jesus Christ in his books. No news of salvation. No joy of Christmas in his books. He was confused in his dream. And then he went out in the dream with the streets. The streets were full of sadness, a lot of fighting, struggle, sadness, sorrow. There was no joy. And then he went back to his office, and it was still in his dream. Okay? Somebody knocked at the door and said to him, "Mrs. So-and-so is very sick, sir. Sir, Reverend, please visit her." And he went to visit this very sick person. And he didn't know what to say to the sick person. There was no good news for him to say. He was confused. He went back. It was still in his dream. He was dreaming a long time. And then in his dream, news came that the lady who was sick died already. He went, he put on his gown, you know, pastors use their gowns for the program, we call it Indonesia. And he had to perform the funeral. He had to officiate the funeral. He was standing at the grave site, and he read from the liturgy. And there were some words missing. He only mentioned about, "Let us deliver this lady. She came from the earth to birth, ashes to ashes." You know, we pastors say that. I was pastoring in Australia 4 years, I used to say that. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes. And then he thought, there should be something else. And namely about delivering his soul to God to gain eternal life. No! The liturgy was cut short, only from earth to earth, ashes to ashes. From the earth you came, you go back to the earth. And then suddenly, when he went back in his dream, he woke up. And then he realized how sad it was before the coming of Jesus Christ. How terrible it was before the coming of Jesus Christ. No wonder we read in our Bible just now, yeah? That darkness covered the earth. Darkness symbolizes sorrow, sadness, confusion, illiteracy included, and so on and so forth. There's so many evil things symbolized by darkness. Darkness covered the earth. And the gross darkness, the people, covered the people. Yes. We thank God for the coming of Jesus Christ. That's why we prepare for Christmas. As our sermon says, your life has come. And we are preparing for Christmas to celebrate the coming of the light. We rejoice greatly. I also rejoice that I know Jesus Christ. I also rejoice that I am a Christian, that I know that my sins have been forgiven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Isn't that what we just sang in the song? Just by having faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven. And then we are born of God, justified and sanctified. The Holy Spirit works in us. We are guided by the Holy Spirit. Now, we live under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. He says that the time of rejoicing, we should celebrate that. Celebrate. So, the Bible says, arise. The light has come. The light indeed has come. We must rejoice. So, the light is in us. Because whoever receives the Lord Jesus also receives the light. The Lord is with us, and we are like a kind of light to the world. That is why we must love people. If we don't love people, how can we say that we are the light? The light, because the Lord is living with us, and we are like a light walking everywhere, and people will see Jesus Christ in us. By our love, people will know that we are disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ. By our help, people will know them. People will just know them. They may not say, oh, he's a Christian, he's a Christian, he's a follower of Jesus. But deep inside their hearts, they will know. I think the followers of the Lord Jesus Christ are reflecting the light that is eternal. So we who have received the Lord Jesus Christ are like lights in the world, walking here and there. Isn't Jesus say, you are the light of the world, you are the salt of the earth? Yes. And the Bible does not expect nations will come to your light. Nations will come to your light. Slowly. But light will draw many people to Jesus Christ. Long ago, the light of Jesus Christ drew the wise men, the wise men from the east, the wise men from the east. Three of them according to the Bible. Sometimes I think that one of them might be a Babylonian. Which is so, because in our language, you know, the gift that they brought to Jesus, frankincense and myrrh, and gold maybe from China, frankincense maybe from India, maybe the myrrh, you know, in Indonesia it's called kemenyan. And kemenyan is found in the Batak Lake. Who knows? One of them might be a Batak Lake. Who knows? But maybe, yeah, the Kebanyan, the world was sold to India, and India took it with him to see Jesus. Three of them went to see the light of Christ drew these kings to himself. It also symbolizes that the light of Christ draws people to him from every direction, from every level of life. Kings, ordinary people, will come to the Lord Jesus Christ for salvation. So we bring people to Jesus Christ. We bring people to Jesus. Since I was a child, I was already taught by my father to pray. And to use me to become a preacher. To bring good news to the nations. Yes, good news. In my language, it is called to return Bible to the people. And I think God was kind in this time. He can listen to my prayer and bring a preacher. So it is true, we draw people to Christ. We preach because we want to draw people to Jesus Christ. Because the message is very, very important. Very important. That is why Christmas is very important, because we celebrate the event in which God revealed himself to human beings. In a special way, God has revealed himself to human beings in many ways, but in and through his Son Jesus Christ in a special way. Yes, so Christmas is the event that we symbolize the event in which God revealed himself to human beings in a special way. Reveal his love, reveal our salvation. So my friends, let us prepare for Christmas and let us rejoice. And I understand the Empire will also go out for caring to praise the Lord. Be with them and may the Lord use them to bring and to proclaim the gospel to part of the world. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, in the name of your Son Jesus Christ, we praise you, Lord, for you. You know that Christmas is very important because it symbolizes coming of Jesus, your special revelation to human beings. Oh God, we need us to have as we continue to prepare for Christmas, as we continue to make other necessary things in relation to Christmas. In the name